Today we find that marriage has become more of a show and a fashion. You know, so there are cases where fine, they may do marriage in the mosque, you know, nikah karne ka hai, but then they have the walima and big grounds where they spend crores of rupees, you know, hundreds of thousands of dollars, and they want to show that, you know, how much they have. And the mehr, as I told you earlier, maybe 76, maybe just 50,000, 1 lakh a person is spending crores in the marriage. So how much mehr should he give? So this really is not what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants. And it is nothing but the verse of the Quran of Surah Isra, chapter number 17, verse number 26-27, where it says that not be a spendthrift. For verily, a person who's a spendthrift is the brother of the devil. So doing israf is haram in Islam. You become a brother of the devil. What should be done to revive the sunnah? What should be done is that you should set examples and see to it that you make the marriage simple. And that reminds me that when I got married in 1993, that's about 16 years back, and some of you may be aware that my wife is from Pune. So, but naturally we were discussing where to have the marriage, and so it's a normal culture, inverted commas, a custom, that normally the nikah takes place in the girls' city if they are not from the same city. So we had a big problem. They said, "Why we should have in Pune?" I said, "No, we should have in Bombay." So he said, "Why should I have in Pune?" I said, "I'll give you a reason why I should be in Bombay. I want to do a simple nikah. I want to set an example." She said, "She wants to do a simple nikah." I said, "There are more people." So finally, I was able to click the deal and have the marriage in Bombay. So we had the marriage in Jama Masjid. We approached the Jama Masjid here in the Coffin Market, which is the largest. And they were reluctant that women should not come to the mosque. Yes, they can, but they can sit at the side. And so we had a problem. So finally, we were able to convince the Jama Masjid of Bandra, where we could take a school which was attached to the Jama Masjid. And mashallah, we had a nikah. And it was a grand nikah, according to me. Grand in the sense that, though when we told the people that, you know, do make arrangement. And normally in a nikah, how many people come? 100, 150. If you have a nikah in the mosque, how many do you expect? 100, 150. We said, there may be more people, so you're laughing. Abhi tak ki kabhi ye angan ne bhara. This small part did not fill, what do you expect? So it'll have some more chadai, so you're laughing. But by Allah's grace, alhamdulillah. There are more than 2,000 people who turned up in the mosque, in the gents, and several few hundred ladies, mashallah. And mashallah, we did start the nikah, I think, about 10 minutes earlier than the time. We had a good khutbah, mashallah. It was simple. Fine, people couldn't recognize who was the dullah because I was just dressed up in kurta pajama, alhamdulillah. And we saw it was absolutely simple. And we did print a card, which has become, mashallah, very popular. Many people are emulating it. We mentioned that the best marriage is that in which the least expense is made. Hadith of the Prophet Muhammad. The best marriage is that in which the least expense is made. And then we printed on the card that, oh, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide our marriage to the best of understanding. Picking up the hadith and Quranic verses, and then the verse of the Quran, Surah Rum, chapter 30, verse 21, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put mercy and love between the heart of the men and women. So we did make a card, mashallah, and we distributed. And mashallah, it was a very simple marriage. One person said, itni simple marriage should be an example, video recording hona chahiye. So I said, if I had done video recording, would it have been the simple then? So mashallah, I mean, there was no video recording. It was simple, and there were many non-Muslims who came also, mashallah. Many non-Muslims came for the nikah. It was very simple. Mashallah, we had a problem that now there are many people who are going to come from Pune, so we have to accommodate them. I mean, I'm just telling you, alhamdulillah has blessed us that we could accommodate in 5-star hotel also, but then that wouldn't be a good example. So finally, we thought what to do. So then, mashallah, my sister-in-law, she said that, okay, fine, my brother got 2 flats, so we can accommodate there. The reason was that we want to spend less. Not that we could not afford it. Allah has given us, mashallah, we could have kept all the guests in 5-star hotel. But that would break the rule of a simple nikah. So without hiring a hotel, mashallah, and my sister-in-law's brother, mashallah, Aman bhai here, and Shine bhai. So both of them, mashallah, they offered their flat, their twin flat, and we just had the beddings. And it was a simple, and whatever requirement was fulfilled. And in the walima is a sunnah, which would call our relatives and close, that is a sunnah. But we did go a bit different, away from the sunnah, to implement the sunnah. You know, it's a bit different. Away from the sunnah means not the sunnah, the muqaddah. But away from the sunnah means we have to call as many friends, good to call friends. But now the norm has become that you do a nikah, as I said, in a mosque, and then call thousands of people in a big ground, and do decorations, spend crores of rupees, that doesn't serve the purpose. What we did, we call only immediate. My brother and sister, and my father's brothers and sisters, immediate. And my wife's and same, 19 people. 19 people and about 30, 40 from the orphanage, 40 or 50. And mashallah, remember we spent about 3,500 something on the Walima. I remember, mashallah. So it was a sample Walima where 3,500 odd rupees, mashallah, and a total about 50, 60 people, out of which, because the hadith says, the best of Walima is that in which more poor people are called. So we saw to it that the number from the orphanage was larger than what we had. So we set an example, went to one extreme. Committing excess is haram in Islam. Going to an extreme is not haram. So I'm not saying this is the sunnah, but because it has become a norm where people are calling thousands of people, etc., and flashing their wealth, etc., what we did, what I told my parents, that okay, what we saved, mashallah, with that money we set up the IRF, alhamdulillah, Islamic Research Foundation. And what my parents wanted to give a flat, so I said, okay, instead of that, by the office of Islamic Research Foundation, and Allah has given barakah. So if we had done the marriage like the way we, Allah has given us, mashallah, where we can spend a lot. So here what we have to do, that if you want to revive the sunnah, you have to go a step forward and set an example, have a simple nikah, best in the mosque, and that's it. Give some dates, that's it. Give dates. And if you have to have a reception, then see to it that if the reception is there, it is simple, it's not extravagant, there's no music, there is proper hijab, there's proper segregation of the ladies and gents. In this way, we should set an example. But the best is, in today's age, have a simple nikah. You may have to give card or call people, but see, do it in the mosque, and that's it. Avoid the reception. If you have to give walima, have it at your home. Call a few close people. Don't have to be 19, what I call. It can be 50, it can be 100, it can be 200. But don't see to it that there is a 10-course meal. Fine, you can have a 2-3-course meal, no problem. One sweet dish, dalgosh, or whatever you prefer. And if that money you invest in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, your marriage will be more successful. And Allah will bless you more. And this is only possible if both the family of the husband and wife, they're of that thinking. So that is the reason if you want to set an example, you have to marry a husband who also wants to set an example. So best part is depending upon the life partner you choose. So all this will only come into play if you choose the right partner. And that is the reason at that time in 90s, I remember, in the early 90s, I mean, my sister was in charge. She was supposed to choose. We could not find anyone, so we had to go to Pune. So mashallah, I had to get from Pune, alhamdulillah, the criteria that we wanted. And now mashallah, this whole thing has spread, and the Irish ladies wing was formed, mashallah, and which wasn't there before my marriage. So after the marriage, the work expanded, the work increased, the Irish ladies wing was formed. And I told my wife that, see, once I get married, I promise you 4,000 a month. I'll give you 4,000 rupees a month. If you can run the house in that, you can marry me. I'm a doctor, but don't think I will give you lakhs of rupees. And mashallah, she was earning much more than that when she got married. Mashallah, but she agreed. Fine. But now I'm giving more than 4,000 rupees. Allah has blessed, alhamdulillah. That's the minimum I said. So what we realized, mashallah, that if you take a life partner who's of the same view, that is the time you can expand, and that is the time you can grow Islamically, and that is the time you can set more example. If my wife was not a da'i, I would not be able to set example. I would have been able, but maybe I would be able to do 25% what I'm doing now. Maybe 20%, maybe 30%. But life would have become miserable. So what we realize that if you have to set example to the world, you have to choose a life partner who has the same view and who has the same ideology. So if you want to set example, sister, to revive the sunnah, not only in marriage, even after marriage, so you have to choose a life partner who's virtuous, and that would be the best, because the beloved Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said that there are four criteria which you look while choosing a life partner. One is wealth, second is beauty, third is nobility, and fourth is virtue. And amongst them, the best is virtue. So if you choose a virtuous life partner, inshallah, you will set many examples in society. Hope that answers the question, sister.